Lovely to see you again.
Nice to see you too.
Okay, remind everybody of your name.
My name is Gattis Kandis.
Do you know, this is the only comedian I've ever found funny.
Well, look, Gattis, welcome back. The stage is yours.
Good luck.
All of it?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you. So, you know, now is after a few cold days, it's getting warm outside. And I like the warm weather because it makes me warmer. That's my warm-up joke. When my chicken has a birthday, I don't tell him because he would not understand. So, I have another animal joke. Woof, 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 woof. That's a joke you can take home for your dog. Simon, have you got a dog?
3.
Will you tell your dogs my joke?
Yeah? I was thinking about that when you said it.
Yeah, let me hear it.
Woof, 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 woof.
Not sure they're gonna understand. Can you try it with my accent?
Woof, 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 woof.
Thank you for making me sound so sexy. So, does anybody like seeing couples kiss in public? No? No, well, I do. And every time I do, I always go up to them and I stare directly at them. And usually they stop. And then they ask me, do you mind? And I'm like, I don't mind. My name is Gattis Kandis. And in case you want to follow me, this is what I look like from behind. Thank you.
Oh, Gattis.
Alicia.
Do you know, I absolutely love you.
Thank you.
Your jokes are just ridiculous. And I like how you deliver them, which is just like you've accidentally found the stage.
You are actually, like I said, the only comedian that's really ever made me laugh. Your jokes are so stupid, I find that funny.
Thank you.
Gattis, you are a real original. And anyone who doesn't get it is thick. You know what? You're kind of sexy as well.
Oh.
Yeah.
Let's get a bit of atmosphere. I'm not messing about 3 of them straight away. Hey, hey, up, hey, 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 up, hey, 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 hey. Oh, I got some music stopped. No, my fault, I forgot. There used to be 2 of us. That's the first gag. I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll do a bit of balloon modelling. Alicia, can I ask you to name an animal? Give me a challenge. Go on, give me a challenge. Any animal.
Elephant. I'm sorry. That's so lovely.
Any other animal? I'll tell you what I'll do. I've seen this done on Britain's Got Talent before, this mind reading stuff. And I'm into that Derren Brown. He simply puts ideas into people's heads without them realizing it. I'm going to make you think of a very specific animal now, Alicia. When you get a clear image of the animal that I'm sending to your brain, shout out the name of the animal so everyone can hear loud and clear, and woof, I'll make it as fast as that. So when you get a clear image of the animal, woof, woof, that's how fast. What? Just
dog,
say dog. I've only got 4 minutes.
Dog, nine,
four.
Dog.
Balloon up, balloon up. Hardest part of this is blowing the balloon up.
Look at his cheeks.
Forget it. I'll do something else. Enjoy now the beautiful sound of the Spanish guitar. I've just got to get the guitar, which is situated just over here. Forward.
Pienso que un sueño parecido no volverá más. Y me echa a volar en el cielo infinito.
is a fairy tale of love. Thank you.
This is the story about love. When a guy meets a girl in a bar, he sees the girl, he looks at her, and all he wants to say is a great big
hello. Is it me you're looking for?
She looked lovely. The dress that night she was wearing was gold. She wasn't looking at him, so he showed her his best dance moves. What does the fox say? What the fox say?
Every day I'm shuffling.
Hey, you look thirsty. You want a drink? What you want?
Tequila.
What?
Tequila.
Why?
It makes me happy.
Fair enough. The girl looks at the guy and says, I'm sorry, I've got to go to the toilet. Don't go, he says. Please don't go.
Please don't go.
I love this act.
The girl comes back.
I'm so excited. I just can't hide it. I'm about to lose control and I think I like it.
The girl laughs at the guy and he says, hey, wanna come back to my place for a coffee? The guy says, hey,
I got a feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night.
So the guy got with the girl and now they've been together for 45 years.
If I could turn back time.
And that is the fairy tale of love.
Thank you for watching.
Hello. Nice to meet you. Hello, everyone. Hi.
Hello.
Sorry, bit nervous.
Who are you?
I'm Phil W. Green. I'm 21, and I'm going to be doing comedy impressions. Hooray!
Philip, do you do this full time?
No, I don't, no.
What do you do?
I work at Body Shop at the moment as a customer consultant.
I bet your dream is to be a big international
yes,
star.
Yes, I'd love to be on stage.
I'm Philip Green, I'm 21, and I'm a customer consultant at Body Shop, but it's not what I want to do forever.
Yeah.
Have you ever done anything like this before, then?
Not this, no. Never done, no. I'm going to go out there and just have a lot. As soon as I'm out there, that's it. Can't come off.
You'll be fine.
I have never performed this talent in front of anyone, apart from my friends. I am so nervous to go on that stage in front of all those judges and all those people, because I don't know what they're going to think. Are they going to buzz me? I don't know. I like to think I've got what it takes to win. I like to think that I've got what it takes to win Britain's Got Talent.
Philip, did you bring anyone with you?
So, my friend Christy.
Did she work at Body Shop?
She did, but she's recently left.
Why?
Because she found a better job.
Found a better job!
Sorry!
Where?
She now works at Barrett's, so... Shoes!
I hope he's good after all of this.
OK, well, look, Philip, you've got roughly 2 minutes. Let's do it.
OK. Hello, I'm Natalie Cassidy. And today, we're going to be health working out. So everyone put your hands out in front of you, spread your legs and do some squats. Lie down the baby on Martin Fowler's sofa. Isn't that right? Don Cotton would be proud, wouldn't she? It's so nice to be here on my new show. And today's guest is absolutely fantastic. You know what? I'm going to meet her. Hello. Oh, thanks for having the show, Lorraine. Oh, I'm so nervous. Oh, come on.
And then, oh, I was on Koala Jungle recently. Oh my God. I mean, I saw those ones and I was like, whoa. And then I saw even more ones and I was like, whoa. And then they tried to make me eat the ones and I was like, whoa. And I was like, whoa. And then I was being sick everywhere.
Oh my goodness, have you seen the bacteria in here? It is awful. Isn't that right, Kim?
Oh, my love. Oh, that stinks. Dunge, it's me, Louis Spence, dancing. Everyone like to duck. Come on, duck. Everyone, come on, duck. Everyone, duck. Duck. And down. Duck. And down. And Spence! Duck! Oh. Ooh. Oh.
Him. I like him a lot.
The brilliant thing about your act was that you had us laughing before you even did anything.
Oh, thanks, Amanda.
David!
You're like a butch version of me. You're a very, very funny guy. I'd like to see some more of you in the act as well. Because you are hysterically funny as you as well.
Are you sure you're not related to Stacey Solomon?
I wish I was. I've seen her from a distance and I was like, Stacey. But no.
I think you're really funny, lovable.
Do you need a wee?
No. I'm just really nervous. Sorry.
Simon?
It was like the world record for how many impersonations you can do in 2 minutes. I found it difficult to keep up with some of them. But the ones that were great.
Oh, thanks.
But you are a naturally funny guy.
Oh, thanks.
Slightly bonkers. But I like that.
We're gonna take a vote. David, yes or no?
I'm gonna say yes.
It's a yes from me.
Simon?
And we have actually had some good impressionists on the show this year. So you have got some competition. But I am going to say yes.
Yay! That's four yeses. You're through for the next round.
Thank you so much. It's nice to meet you all. See you soon. Bye-bye.
Yeah!
Oh, my gosh.
Well done. Well done. You did it.
Funny guy.
He is very funny.
It might be quite fun to have two impressionists in the final.
In an impression of.
So your first time out on stage doing this, how did it feel?
I'm so glad they laughed. That's all I can say. Like,
good. Yeah. Well, we'll see you again. You got four yeses. Well done.
Thank you.
Well
done. Thank you very much. Cheers.
Enjoy.
Thank
you. Enjoy. Enjoy.
Enjoy.
See
you next
time.
Hello.
Hello.
What's your name?
My name's Nick Page.
Right. And do you have a day job, Nick?
I am a comic all the time. I've been doing it for 16 years.
Okay. Why Britain's Got Talent now?
I've been sort of living from gig to gig and having a laugh, and I got married and we want to have kids, so it's time to make a move and see if I'm good enough.
Yes.
Is this the biggest gig you've ever played?
This is the most terrifying thing I've ever done.
Okay. Well, the stage is yours, Nick.
Thank you. Before I became a self-employed comic, I'd had 19 jobs and no leaving dues. Every job I ever had ended with me being escorted off-site by security, even if my job was security. We're coming up to my wedding anniversary. Let's have a big cheer for my long-suffering wife. However, before that, I had been married 3 previous times. And I have 7 ex-fiancés. Go, It's nice that all my ex-wives and ex-fiancés have made the effort to buy tickets.
Yes.
Simon, you're tight and I'm a terrible person. It's just words. With all things, if you explain it the right way, you can get away with it. If I told you I'd recently given a large cash donation to a charity that gives financial aid to young mums, you'd think that was good, yes? Yeah, but if I said I'd been to a lap dancing club... I haven't even got any hobbies. The nearest I've got to a hobby is this. I quite like highlighter pens. I've got 11. Which is two of each plus a spare orange, obviously. I mean, that's quite impressive, but what I like to do with them is I take them into public buildings like schools and colleges and leisure centres, and I find a notice board with a list of names, and then I just highlight one of the names. And then I go. Try it.
It's a good idea, I'd love to.
When you highlight a name on a notice board, you've just changed a life. I wasn't even planning on doing this. But I looked on a notice board. Thank you very much. I'm Nick Page, good night.
We love Nick, thanks, buddy.
Why were people so excited about that talking dog on Britain's Got Talent? Amanda Holden's been on it for years.
Is that you, Deck? Please, sir, tell us your name.
I'm Ned.
How old are you, Ned?
I'm 8.
So cute.
Where are you from?
Maidstone.
Oh. Who's here with you today?
Well, I'm with my mum, my dad, my stepmum, my sister, my other sister, and my brother.
Fantastic. Do you perform for friends and family? Do you get up in school and do shows?
Yeah.
The stage is yours, sir. Good luck.
Oh, I love him already.
Come on, Ned.
Why were people so excited about that talking dog on Britain's Got Talent? Amanda Holden's been on it for years. And Deck backstage, but I'm never quite sure which one's supposed to be the funny one.
Oh, he's killing us all!
Alicia?
Oh no.
Yeah. Alicia laughing?
Oh no.
Alicia not dancing?
That was good.
Simon.
What's up?
Who reminds me a lot of my dad. He's a cross-dresser. He gets especially cross when he can't find his socks. I was really worried for David Walliams when he swam on the River Thames for charity because of all that garbage going in his mouth. But since I've been watching BGT, I'm relieved it's all coming out again.
Well done, Ned. I loved the way that you took the Mickey out of us. It was really quite savage.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm very well, thank you.
What's your name?
I'm Vladimir Georgievsky.
Great name.
Thank you.
Where do you live?
Swansea.
Swansea?
Yes.
Okay. Are you married?
Yes, we have two sons.
Lovely. What are you going to do for us today?
I bought a trampoline for my kids, for my boys, for, in the back garden. I just started bouncing with them. And some of friends of us told me, you know, I should do Britain's Got Talent.
So do you believe you can win this show?
If I wouldn't believe, I wouldn't be here.
Okay, well, that's good. Good luck. Go
Thank you
it.
Very much.
Secretly really good at trampolining, aren't you?
Thank you.
That was great. And we're always saying we're looking for something we've never seen before. And I know Simon would really appreciate the bits where you really could have been injured very badly.
I really enjoyed it because it goes back to the silent movie days. It just shows that a relatively young audience can still appreciate it and still laugh.
Yeah, it was fantastic. What do you hope to achieve from this if you do well?
Royal Variety for me would be a dream come true.
That was really, really good.
Thank you. Thank you, Sam. Thank you.
I think you'd be perfect for Royal Variety.
Thank you.
You choreographed that to perfection.
Thank you, Sam. Thank you.
My favourite act today, I'm going to say yes.
Well, thank you.
It's a yes from me.
Thanks.
It's a yes from me.
You got 4 yeses. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you. Hello, what's your name?
Hello, my name is Lee, and for obvious reasons, I'm also known as the Lost Voice Guy.
Okay, and how long have you lost your voice?
I just knew you were going to ask something that I hadn't thought about beforehand. So please excuse the awkward silence while I type out my answer. I've been speechless for 37 years.
Wow. Tell me why you decided to enter the show this year.
I think I entered Britain's Got Talent for the same reason everyone does. To meet Ant and Dec.
This is all going so well up until that point. The stage, Lee, is yours.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. As you may be able to tell, I'm a struggling stand-up comedian who also struggles to stand up. To be honest, I'm not sure how good I am. I'll leave that for you to decide. But just so you know, if you don't laugh at the disabled guy, you are going to hell. When I realized I'd never be able to talk again, I was speechless. I have lived in Newcastle all my life.
Yes!
But for some reason, I still haven't picked up the accent. I can see that some of you are trying to figure out where you know me from. Maybe it would help if I started saying phrases such as, the next train to arrive on platform 4 is the 12:52 service to London King's Cross. And, from my time at the post office, please go to cashier number 8. I got the train here today. I always like to sit in those seats for disabled people. I was about halfway here when another disabled person got on and asked me to move. I didn't realize I'd be playing disabled top trumps when I got on, or I would have dressed more special. Needless to say, I didn't give up my seat. Who cares if he was both blind and deaf? I was there first. It was very awkward. He couldn't see that I was still there. And I couldn't tell him I wasn't moving because I can't speak. Before I leave you, I have one more thing to say. I hate that we have so many, politically, correct words to describe disabled people now. It's all special needs, special schools, special Olympics. I don't know what is so special about me. That is why it always alarms me when I hear about special forces going to war. You've been a fantastic audience. Goodbye.
Bloody brilliant.
Good evening.
Good evening.
What's your name?
I'm Mickey.
Mickey.
Yeah.
Where are you from, darling?
I'm from the beautiful city of Leeds.
How old are you, Mickey?
I'm 36.
Do you have a day job or is this your full-time job?
I am a part-time primary school teacher.
Oh, lovely. Lovely.
Are you enjoying your food? Yeah, you've got to eat, you know.
The stage is yours, Mickey. Go for it.
Thank you very much. Cheers. This is called the absolutely amazing song.
Yes.
About travelling round Europe.
Oh.
That rhymes.
I like him.
I'm off to Paris in a Yaris. This next song. I know this is supposed to be a comedy routine, but I've suffered loss recently.
Oh, no.
So I just want to get this off my chest. Joe, I'll play the song because I get a bit emotional talking about it. I can't believe I've lost you. I can't believe you've gone. I need you to know that you did nothing wrong. First time I saw you, just hanging there. The checkout lady said, do you want to buy one of these? And I said, all right, go on then, yeah. You were my bag for life.
It's what?
My bag for life.
Forever. What?
My bag for life. Life.
We
could have saved the world together. You can either buy a teeth carrier bag or a bag for life, which is better quality and a bit more expensive.
Yes, I paid the price.
You cost almost 10 pence and I only used you twice. The other bags I use compared to you are slack. I always feel that the handle strap is gonna... Has it happened to you a lot as well? Oh, back for life.
Hello. What's your name?
My name's Jack.
Jack. Jack.
Carol.
And how old are you?
14 years.
And tell me a little bit more about you.
I'm a professional gymnast.
My name's Jack Carroll, I'm 14, and today I'm going to be doing a bit of stand-up comedy. I've had cerebral palsy since I was born, and yeah, basically, still got it, won't go away.
It's impossible for him to move around without some kind of aid, either a wheelchair or a walking frame. That seems to be the least of his worries. His big worries are whether his jokes make people laugh or not.
I use my cerebral palsy in my act because in comedy, a lot of times, your weaknesses are your strengths. It's like the elephant in the room, and then when you mention it, they go, and they can relax and enjoy the rest of the funny jokes.
He wants to make people laugh and he wants to make something of his life, and yeah, I'm really proud of him.
I'm not looking to help people in need because I'm a horrible, selfish individual. But if people do find some comfort or some inspiration from what I do, then brilliant bonus. I'm never going to be Usain Bolt, right? That's sorted. But maybe I can focus on my strengths, which is, you know, bring joy to the world.
All right, well, best of luck.
All right, cheers. Don't worry, I know what you're thinking. Harry Potter's had a nasty Quidditch accident. Do you know what I can't stand? Sorry, let me re-emphasise. Do you know what? I can't stand. But look on the bright side. I've never had to queue at Disneyland. Now, I'm just going to throw a disclaimer out there. If I do get too energetic, please stop me. I want to keep my benefits. But otherwise, how would I heat the jacuzzi? I'm joking. It's a pool. I was at the cinema seeing the new James Bond film the other day, and it got me thinking, you know, maybe I would have liked to have had a go, you know, being James Bond, but obviously I'm a bit inhibited. Ah, Mr. Bond, I've been expecting you. No lift. But this isn't the first Britain's Got Talent event I've been to. I was actually at the live tour in Manchester, funnily enough, 2 years ago. And the staff, they couldn't have been more helpful, moving people out the way, getting us to a seat. And then when we finally got there, the view was just fantastic. And we sat down and my sister, she tapped me on the shoulder, turned round, and I'll never forget this as long as I live. She said, "Jack, we are so lucky you're disabled." You cannot take her anywhere. Thank you very much. I've been Jack Carroll. Goodbye.
She's got a standing ovation as well.
Right, Jack. I'm going to have to go to David, first of all.
Jack, you are a comedy genius.
Thank you.
I wasn't as funny as you are 14. I'm not even as funny now as you are at 14 years old. It was incredible. Every joke was a winner.
Thank you. Cheers. Thank you.
Jack,
You made me laugh before the act even started, and
I know I've got a funny face.
No, you just. Jack, the thing that's great is nobody feels sorry for you. You're self-deprecating. You're hilarious, and I think you've got a huge future.
Well, I've got to tell you, Jack, you've got one of the most refreshing attitudes. You made fun, you know, of what you've gone through, and you made it funny, which is really, really difficult. You've just got an incredible personality. And I'm really happy that I met you.
Thank you.
Come on, 4 yeses.
Okay, David, yes or no?
Gigantic yes.
Alicia.
100% yes.
Amanda.
Yes for me, Jack.
Thank you.
Jack, you have. I think you know what's coming. 4 yeses. Yes.
Best gig ever.
Well done, that was brilliant.
I love him. He likes
brilliant.
Him.
Yeah, he's really funny. You don't have to take his age or his cerebral palsy into consideration. Well, just a really, really funny comedian.
Fantastic comments from the judges. 4 yeses.
Yes.
And a standing ovation from the crowd.
Something that I can't do. I think they were just rubbing it in.
Not only do I treat my body like a temple shown, I treat my body like the Catholic Church. Full of bread, wine, and the constant urge to worship a man in a loincloth.
Best of luck, pal.
An amazing time out there. It's all yours. Onto the star.
Now, yeah?
Yeah, go for it. Have fun, mate. Enjoy.
Hello.
Hello, how are you?
I'm good.
Let's start with your name, please.
My name's Liam Bannigan.
Well, nice to meet you.
Thank you.
So where are you from?
I'm from Essex.
How old are you?
25.
And what do you do, Liam?
I work with my dad as a plumber.
Okay, how long have you been doing that for?
For about 2.5 years.
All right, Liam, good luck.
Thank you very much. Okay, guys, so I want to start off real quick by saying that I'm a gay man. Sorry, ladies. No, but I do feel the need to say that, though, as a lot of people seem to mistake me for a lesbian. Yeah, apparently the man boobs kind of throw people off a little bit. Yeah, but say what you want about the man boobs, there is no greater feeling in life than getting home after a long day of work and just whipping off that bra. Am I right, ladies? Simon, you know what I'm talking about.
I'm so with you.
But guys, when I'm not being a lesbian, I actually work with my dad as a plumber, as I said, and safe to say that we don't get along. I think it's obvious. So basically, my dad, he never trusts me while we're there. He never does. Like, he'll ask me to go to the van to get a hammer, for example, but he'd go into full detail of what a hammer is. Like, I think he thinks I'm gonna go to the van and, I don't know, come back in like a bright pink ball gown. And be like, Dad, the craziest thing happened. Madonna was there, it was a whole thing, you won't believe it. We do argue a lot at work as well. So as a way of getting like my secret revenge, I've decided to treat everything on a building site like a West End performance. Goes down a hoot, as you can imagine. So an example of this, right? My dad, he chews gum all day at work, like so loud, right? So what I do now, I grab the screw gun, I go up to him and I go, "You pop that gum one more time." He had it coming. He had it coming. He only had himself to blame.
And don't be afraid to add in a bit of a kickball change, you know, some shimmy shimmies. Think of the steps, ladies. Woo!
I could probably think of the steps a little bit more in life, not gonna lie to you. I am trying to lose a bit of weight, guys. I feel like it's the mature thing to do since I'm failing miserably at being an adult. My mum's words, not mine. Like I'm still splitting my lip from shoving in too many Pringles. I'm constantly getting my hand stuck in the Pringles can, which is like not a good look. But my brother as well, he's always on at me about losing weight. You know, he's like, Liam, you know, you should treat your body like a temple. And not only do I treat my body like a temple, Sean, I treat my body like the Catholic Church, full of bread, wine, and the constant urge to worship a man in a loincloth. Thank you guys so much. Thank you. Very good.
David, you're on your feet.
Well, I feel like we're at the birth of something really special here, because what I loved about that was how authentic it was, how authentic it was to you. You're super likable. You're obviously naturally funny. I mean, I just think you're going to go super, super far, so I'm really, really excited for you from that audition.
Thank you.
The big audience, they were on your side the whole time. Everyone was willing you to do well. And like David said, it was so authentic. I could listen to the Essex banter all night. It is, yes, exactly.
Get that Lambrino.
Exactly that. The more you are yourself, the more we love you. So well done.
Exactly. You didn't turn into a different person. It felt very relaxed. I think you did really well. It was inventive. It was natural. It was funny. And I can't wait to see you develop, because I think you've got masses of potential.
Thank you so
really
much.
Really good.
I was going to ask you, Liam, so if you were to make the final, have you got something in your head which is kind of more of a musical production in addition to what you do?
Yeah, shockingly, yes.
Yes. Which, no, you're very funny, very original. I think I know where this is going to go. Let's start with David.
Let me kick this off, Liam, with a yes.
Thank you so much.
Alicia.
It's a yes for me, Liam.
Amanda.
It's a yes for me.
Another one that counts. Liam, you got four yeses.
Thank you so much, guys. Thank you.
Hi, welcome. What's your name, please?
Noel. Noel James.
How old are you, Noel, if you don't mind me asking?
52.
What do you do, Noel?
I invigilate in schools.
What's that?
When the kids are doing exams in schools and you sort of look after them, you know, make sure they don't cheat and stuff.
Yeah.
If you'd have taken any O-levels or A-levels, Simon, you'd know that.
Are you with anyone today?
Unfortunately, my girlfriend couldn't make it because she doesn't exist.
Well, look, good luck.
Thank you very much. Good evening, Blackpool. My name is Noel. My full name is, in fact, Noel Wynne James. That's right, I don't pronounce the in fact. And I'm glad you're laughing, because I've had a terrible day. You've cheered me up. Do you know, I was woken up at 4 a.m. this morning. The phone rang. I thought, who's ringing me at this time? I picked the phone up. Achoo! Down the line. Achoo! It was a cold caller at that time.
Very good. Very good.
But as you can see, ladies and gentlemen, I brought my instrument with me tonight. I do hope you enjoy this next tune. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Now, this is... sorry, I just bring the guitar to keep it in shape, you see. I don't know if you've seen one of these before. This is an old Welsh instrument. It's got a Welsh name, that's right. It's called a bag. And I am going to play a tune for you, ladies and gentlemen. This is not an original tune. This is a cover.
He's good, isn't he? We like Noel.
And some of you may recognise it. Here we go. Yeah, it's a famous film from the 70s.
It's the Elephant Man. You up for some music, ladies and gentlemen?
Yeah!
So, ba-ba, black sheep. Of any wool. Yes, sir, yes, sir. Lord, I got three bags full. I said, ba! Sheep solo, ba! That's 12 bar blues.
I've got a little tip for you, gents in the room. I can't speak for the ladies. If you are having a bath with a bath bomb, a lot of people fill the bath, throw the bath bomb in, and then get into the bath. I don't do that. I fill the bath, I get in the bath, and then bath bomb under the... get a little bit more for your £4.50.
Hello!
What's your name?
Mike.
How old are you?
39.
What do you do for a living?
I do a bit of casual work. Building and gardening. Good stuff, outdoor stuff. I do stand up at the weekends, but it's not really... Well, I earn a living from it, but I need to top up because I live on my own.
Oh. OK. We want to see what you're going to do, Mike.
Thank you. I had a terrible breakup a couple of years ago. We were together for a good chunk of time, 5.5 years. We were in a serious relationship. Serious because we never had fun together. It was a bit of a low point, actually. I remember it was Monday night. I'd been back at home with Mum and Dad for about 2 weeks, and I found myself typing into Google, is it normal for you to miss someone that you've broken up with? I did learn one thing from that Google search, and that's that I must be very feminine. Every single answer was aimed at women. Of course, you'll miss him. I'm going, it's her. Remember the reason you broke up with him? I'm going, it's her. So I just went to the shop and got a big bag of Maltesers, a bottle of rosé and had a bath bomb. It's a cracking night. I love a bath bomb, me. It was actually my ex-girlfriend that got me into them. She bought me a couple for our last Christmas together. I mean, it was a rubbish main present, I'll be honest with you, but... As I said, we're not together anymore, but she lives on. She lives on every time I go into Lush to buy myself a bath bomb. I can't admit I'm buying bath bombs for myself. It's not a very manly, masculine item to buy, is it? So I wander in there like I don't know where I am. My girlfriend sent me. She's after some bath grenades. I don't know what they are. She doesn't like the glittery ones, I know that much. Get stuck in her chest there. Oh, no, she just don't like them. I love a bath generally. I don't always have a bath bomb. They're £4.50 a throw, aren't they? They're for birthdays and Boxing Days, special occasions. But... And I've got a little tip for you, gents in the room. I can't speak for the ladies. If you are having a bath with a bath bomb, a lot of people fill the bath, throw the bath bomb in, and then get into the bath. I don't do that. I fill the bath, I get in the bath, and then bath bomb under the... Get a little bit more for your £4.50. So that's me. That's me. Thank you.
You've got a very, very unique comic voice. Brilliant material. I've never heard anything like that before, so I thought it was fantastic.
Cheers.
Your whole style is really cool, really interesting, really laid back, and the act just got funnier and funnier as it went along. So, well done.
Thank you. Cheers. Cheers.
I think this is you, isn't it?
Yeah.
I mean, do you ever jump up and down?
No. Not very often.
It was like being at an Oasis concert, and the music's run out, and Liam decides to tell a few jokes. You're really funny.
Cheers.
And I'm with you with the bath bombs. I absolutely get it.
He loves the bath.
Oh, right. You always wait till you're in the bath, trust me, before you drop it. That's what it's all about. So I thought this wasn't going great, but actually you completely turned it around, Mike, and you're one of my favourite comics we've had on the show so far.
Oh, cheers.
It is time to vote, Simon.
I'm going to say yes.
Cheers.
I'm going to say yes.
I'm saying yes.
Well, as the nation's favourite TV judge, 4 yeses, Mike. Well done. You got it,
Hello.
Hello.
What's your name, please?
My name is Marcus Spurdman.
And where are you from, Marcus?
I'm from Essex.
How old are you, Marcus?
I'm 52.
Okay, what do you do?
Used to be in a band. From that, my bandmate suggested maybe I should try comedy.
Tell me, what's the worst gig you've ever done?
The worst gig I've ever done? I went all the way to Plymouth and was wearing leather-soled shoes, ran onto stage, it was very wet, I slipped straight over into the front, landed with my face in the front row and never really recovered. Do you think someone would find that funny?
Okay, and do you think you can win?
I'd like to think so, yes.
Okay, Marcus. Yeah. Well, good luck.
Thank you very much, thank you.
He's a brave man for rocking denim on denim, though.
Yeah, yeah. I'll start with a joke. Seems like a good idea. Kids are the biggest source of joy you will ever have. Trouble is, they do tend to ruin every other source of joy you ever had. So I hear other parents say stuff like, I'd take a bullet for my child. You know, would you? I'd take a bullet for my child, put it in a gun, and shoot her. My daughter's now 18, I can't believe it. So one of those teenagers wears tons of makeup, you know, she makes RuPaul look like a trucker. When the whole pandemic was kicking off, and I did what many people did here, which was to spend the next 2 years fairly drunk. I need a drink. Oh, it's only 5:30. Better wait till 6 o'clock. All right, 6:45, I'm opening the drink. 6 o'clock, woof. All right, new plan. One more at 6:30, another one at 7, and then I will get up and make my daughter some breakfast. So a couple of years ago, I had a stroke. That's what happened. People don't always believe me because I perhaps don't look like a stroke survivor to you. But what you fail to appreciate is I'm actually 23. I do a lot of work for the Stroke Association for obvious reasons. They asked me to do a benefit gig. Now, you would think as a 2-time stroke survivor, as I am, you ought to be able to make jokes about surviving strokes to other stroke survivors.
Where's this going?
Nope. At one point, someone stood up and went, stroke victims have feelings too, mate. I went, I know, but only down half the side of their body. So, when I was in hospital, I was very heavily sedated and I was wearing like one of those hospital gowns. So sort of, your backside is hanging out for some reason.
Right? Hideous.
The bum cape, as I like to call it. So there I was, heavily sedated. I needed to go to the toilet. It was quite late at night. I parted the bum cape, backed into the toilet, sat down. So far, so good. Were it not for the fact that there was already a blind, naked man sat there. Now, I don't know if you've ever sat naked on another naked man.
No, never.
What you might expect is the person you just sat on to go, get off! What happens, the most beautiful middle-class English thing I think I've ever heard in my life, you just went, oh, I'm sorry, who's that? Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. I have to praise you. I have to praise you.
I have to praise you. Very good.
Oh my God, brilliant. Marcus, honestly, I don't think any of us were expecting that. Bruno.
Oh, I love it. You're not afraid to go there. Your delivery is absolutely spot on. Every gag, you hit the jackpot.
Thank you. I have to praise
you. Alicia.
I think what I like about you is your style is quite dry. I thought every single joke was funny. The kids thing, I am with you, my friend. Well done.
Thank you. Thank you.
Everything you said tonight on stage, I howled at. I mean, I'm glad I'm wearing my big knickers tonight. That's all I'm saying. Well done.
I honestly wasn't expecting this.
No, me neither.
You were just brilliant. And we've never heard jokes like this. I absolutely love you. That is a yes from me.
It's an absolute yes from me.
Alicia.
It's a yes from me.
Bruno.
Yes from me. I've been laughing.
So, very nice to be here. Very cold today. A few days ago, I left the house, it was raining, and I had my umbrella. This man had left the house without his, so he improvised, put a supermarket carrier bag on his head to repel the rain. I couldn't resist it as I walked past him. Unexpected item in bagging area. Now, my heritage is Italian. I speak Italian. I used to watch Italian television when I was a kid to learn, and my favourite show was The Simpsons. But in Italy, every character sounded identical. So you had Homer here.
Donuts, sweet, sweet donut. I wish I had one right now.
You had Homer in Italy.
Donuts. Vuole semplicemente un donut.
You had Marge over here.
Bart, leave Lisa alone and go upstairs.
Oh, that's good.
You had Marge in Italy.
Bart. Lasci stare vai su di sopra.
Now, I love British regional accents. I love foreign languages. So I started learning foreign languages in British regional accents. So I hope you enjoy these. I started learning German with a West Country accent.
All right.
Guten Tag.
My name is Stefano Paolini. Ich bin ein stand-up comedian and voiceover künstler.
Spanish with a Glaswegian twist.
Hola, mi nombre es Stefano Paolini. Voy soy monologuista.
Italian, but with a Northern Irish accent.
Buonasera, io mi chiamo Stefano Paolini.
Chinese with a Geordie accent.
Ni hao. Wu Zhao, Duli Duli Ole, Wu Zia, Stefano Paolini.
Oh, I like that one, that's good.
French with a Brummy accent.
Bonjour, je m'appelle Stefano Paolini. Je suis un stand-up comedian, if what you like.
God almighty, I gotta tell you, Stefano, you started off so badly, and I'm thinking, whoa, this is not gonna go well. And then it just completely switched round to a brilliant, brilliant audition.
Oh, thank you.
David, what did you think?
You are absolute comedy gold someday. What's brilliant is you use the fact you're Italian and the fact you can do amazing voices. Those two things together. And it was absolutely hilarious.
Thank you, David. Thank you.
Lisa, what did you think?
You know, for me, at the beginning, I was a little bit nervous because the jokes fell a little bit under par and I was feeling the audience reaction and they weren't going crazy, but it just got better and better and better and to the point I was ugly laughing.
Okay, great. Thank you. Cheers.
The best thing, you are unique. And it was fantastic. You're bloody brilliant, and I'm saying yes.
Grazie, grazie.
It's a yes from me.
Grazie, thank you.
It's a yes from me. You've got four yeses.
I'm going to impersonate the Bee Gees. Take seconds to make up.
Oh my, whoa!
My baby moves at midnight. Right up to the door. My woman take me high, yeah. should be dancing, yeah. Dancing, yeah.
Yeah! What's next?
I have to confess, when I sing in a falsetto, I feel like I have lost my testicles.
Who's this now?
Better and better.
Who's that?
Elvis.
I'm sorry for I don't look like Elvis. Because it's genetically impossible. Finally, I'm going to impersonate Godfather.
This will be good.
Dear Judgy, I'd like to thank you for helping me organize this meeting. We have associates and heads of different families from England, Scotland, Ireland. Thank you so much.
Hello.
Hello.
What's your name?
My name's Dante.
Oh, I love that name. How old are you, Dante?
13 years old.
Are you supposed to be at school this minute?
Yes, I am, but...
However...
Yeah.
Do welcome. They know why?
Not really, no.
Oh, OK.
We'll keep it a secret.
And what is the reason that you decided to come on Britain's Got Talent?
So I was born with brittle bone disease, and I've came on Britain's Got Talent to show other people like myself that even if you've got some sort of disability or disadvantage, that you can go as far as your imagination wants to take you.
How would you spend the money if you won Britain's Got Talent?
I would buy my mum a giant house.
Aww. Is that who's in the wings, your mum?
Yes, I wouldn't go anywhere without her.
Well, the stage is yours. Good luck.
Thank you.
Oh, bless him.
That's brilliant.
Very good.
God, why did I get it? Me and Dante know each other.
Oh, do you?
We've met a few times. because he said, could you write a book about a boy in a wheelchair? And I dedicated it to Dante.
Is that why you didn't insult him?
You write that song yourself?
Yes, in lockdown.
It really captured you, how cheeky you are, how special you are, and how much you do to inspire others too. So I loved it, Dante.
Thank you, that means so much. Yeah, you're amazing. Very, very cheeky. Your laugh is really naughty as well, isn't it? What is there not to love about you? Well done, Dante. Thank you.
Comedy often has to make you think or make you go, oh, God, are we allowed to say that? And that's when it's the best comedy. So that was a really funny song. Well done.
Thank you.
Yeah, you know, it was just a great audition. And if we put you through to the next round, can I help you write the lyric about someone on this panel?
We'll have to wait and see.
I always say a great audition is one you're going to remember, and I'm going to remember this. It was great. Can I be the first to say yes, please?
It's a yes from me, Dante.
I'm saying yes, Dante.
And it's a yes from me, so that's four yeses. Well done.
Hello.
How are you, David? How are you, love?
How are you?
I'm all right, thanks.
Please tell us your name.
Barbara Nice. Barbara's in Streisand, Nice is in the biscuit, Dave.
Oh. They are nice, those biscuits, aren't they?
They are, love.
And is this your day job, or...?
Well, I jig all over the country, and I just like people making fun of life and having a laugh.
Excuse me, you look familiar. Have we met?
I don't think...
OK, I was thinking... Whether you come on the show before?
No, I've never been on a competition.
This is your first time.
I've never done a competition
wow.
before.
Okay,
love.
Good for you. Yeah.
Lovely teeth, by the way. I just thought, yeah, I just thought it's about time. And if I could go to the Royal Variety performance, that's a dream come true for me.
All right, good luck.
Thanks, love. Right, so I'm going to put my bag for life down. I've got about 49 bags for life. I should never die. But who wants to live forever? Not me, I've got no proper pension. Right, I'm going to take my coat off. I can see the girls, Amanda and Alicia. Nice colour, isn't it, this Mac? It's like an apple green, girls. It's me Apple Mac, ladies and gentlemen. Hey. She's living the vida loca. Hey, come on. Diamonds are forever. Keep your eye on it, love. You look like you keep a good house. So, $4.99. I like a bargain, like I see a lot of you do. So this frock, forget DKNY. This frock was CPL, Cats Protection League. If my husband Ken could see me now, you know, here, auditioning BGT, he'd go mad. He thinks I'm dog sitting for Jean and Jean in Ebden Bridge, so keep it. Mum's the word. You're friendly. That's what I like. I bumped into a very, very good old friend of mine, Unlucky Mary, coming here. She said, Barbara, I'm in trouble with police. I thought, what's new? I said, well, what's been going on? She said, I've been caught speeding while knitting. I know. Apparently, the police said, pull over. She said, no, cardigan. We're living a vida loca. We've got to have a laugh, kids. It's all we've got left.
I love her. I love her.
And this has cheered me up, this has. I was outside having a bit of fresh air, and I got a text. I'm very sorry, Barbara. Your boiler's broken down. It's awful news, isn't it? And I thought, I'm not going doing that audition. I've got to get the bus, go back home, because Ken will go to pieces. It's a crisis. But, you know, in life, do you ever think there's signs?
Yes.
Yeah, right, smashing. There are signs in life. And I looked up at this tree and there was a white carrier bag caught in the branches. And I looked up and I thought, that's 5p up there, Barbara. And then suddenly there was a gust of wind and that carrier bag blew high up, free as a bird. And I thought, forget about the pig in boiler, Barbara. Let it go. That's the cue for the stage dive. Let it go. So those lads, come down here. Give them a round of applause. I met them in the queue. Down here, kid. How are you?
I'm good. I'm really, really good.
I was not expecting to see you today. I've known Kojo for many, many years. Kojo, I'll let you tell my fellow judges about yourself.
I'm a stand-up comedian. Been doing comedy for 20 years. I've spent most of those 20 years encouraging young comedians and helping big-name comedians and opening up for them. And my new fiancé... We've got a little boy called Roman, who's here as well. And she said that it was about time that I started thinking about myself and...
my son.
Who makes you laugh?
Simon Cowell.
That's funny. OK, well, look, Kojo, you know the show. 3 minutes, do your stuff.
Good luck, darling.
Thank you very much.
Come on, Coach! I want a good one.
So, ladies and gentlemen, I'm a new dad for the first time. But all I want to do is be better than my dad, right? My dad had no patience, right? Me and my best friend, Michael Murphy, after school every day, we'd play football on the estate. I had the parent who would ruin that game by calling me inside for something I didn't think was necessary. All you would hear, because I've got African parents, right? My dad would shout like, Kujo, come here. Now, Michael always had a confrontation with my dad. He was like, coach, what's going on, mate? Coach, you're a big man, you're 11. You go in there and you tell him that this enough's enough. Now, ladies and gentlemen, there was a little part of me that believed in Michael's spirit. But then I remembered, he don't live in my house. So I turned to my dad, I said, Dad, what's up? Go to the store and get me Ribena. Ladies and gentlemen, this is all I said. Dad! Can't you get it yourself?
It was 1 p.m, but it got dark real quick.
The pigeons weren't even flying anymore. They came down to warn me. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't have any jokes, I got problems. Have you ever been to a bank, right? Because I'm not really happy with the customer services that we get at banks nowadays, right? Have you ever gone into a bank? You've seen 4 available windows. 4! But there's only 1 person working. Yes. Then you get the woman that works there who walks past the queue and says, don't worry, she won't be long. Go and help her! Why are you out here? You get to the cashier because it's your turn, right? They've now given the cashiers microphones, yeah? So everybody can hear your financial situation. I'm right here, I can hear you, right? And I'm already embarrassed about the amount that I need. So I was discreet, right? I was like, can I get £1.50, please? That weren't enough for her. She had to talk into the mic and get into my business. Sorry, sir, you need £1 to keep the account open? I'm like, why are you shouting? But I told you, I needed the rest of what was in my account. So I said to her, please, can I get that 50 pence? She said to me, how do you want that? I was like, in silence.
Nice.
I was so frustrated that I rushed out of the bank. I rushed out to be greeted by the most creative homeless person I have ever met.
He rushed up to me and said, look, mate, I know you're in a rush, but can I please get 20 pence to get something to eat? Ladies and gentlemen, I looked at him and said, you know where to eat for 20 pence? I said, mate, I'm coming with you. I've got dinner for the both of us. When you're broke, right, and you ain't got no money, there's certain things that you can't enjoy. Like a cab ride, right? You can't enjoy the black cab ride. You can't enjoy it, right? I went into a black cab recently. Me and my mate, we jumped in. He was getting comfortable. Clearly, he's got more money than me. He was looking outside the window, talking to the driver. He fell asleep. Ladies and gentlemen, when you ain't got no money, you only look at one thing, the meter. The experience in a black cab is the most awful thing ever. They charge you before you even speak to the driver. You step in, 250. Hold on a minute. You sit down, £3. Hey! Let's discuss this. Ladies and gentlemen, it's got to a point where I don't even have a destination when I get into a black cab. When a driver says, where do you want to go? I say, take me to £5.
Very good.
My name's Kojo, thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.
Kojo, when you came on, I loved hearing about how you've grafted, how you've honed your act, how you've now got your little family. Yeah, and the act just got better and better, and then by the end you were like, yeah, I'd pay money to see this man. Congratulations.
Thank you so much, man.
I'm so happy right now.
I've always respected you. My respect level for you has just gone way up there, my friend. And let's see how far you can take it now.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Well, you know, when someone's really funny, there is nothing much to say other than you are brilliantly funny. Yeah. You made everyone laugh. You've kind of got all bases covered as a comedian. You're brilliantly likeable. You've got fantastic observational routines. I think you did yourself really proud today.
Thank you so much. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Kojo, what was quite amazing was I felt that you were nervous. Then I could see the audience reacting to you and you reacting to them. But I'm going to be honest with you, Kojo, I don't really like comedians on this show. But I love you.
I really get it.
I have to tell you, I don't know what it is. You are so funny and so unpredictable. You just got the most amazing energy. This is the break you've been waiting for.
Thank you so much.
I could not be happy with you. Thank you. Enjoy this. Hello.
Hello, how are you?
You look happy.
I am. I'm quite delighted. Hello.
What's your name?
My name is Daliso, Daliso Chaponda.
That's an amazing name.
That's a Malawian name.
Malawian.
Yes. So I'm from Malawi, but I live in Manchester.
Why have you come on Britain's Got Talent?
I've come to make the people laugh. I am a comedian.
Oh, yes!
I'm a comedy writer.
I would love the winner of Britain's Got Talent this year to be a comedian.
Oh, no pressure.
No pressure.
Who are you here with?
So I'm here just alone. My brother, he wanted to come. He's a doctor. And he was like, either I should save lives or come with you.
Were your parents disappointed that one of you was a comedian, one of you was a doctor?
They were absolutely horrified because I was studying computer programming. So I had a future. And I just decided, no, let me be a clown.
So we shall see.
Oh, darling, good luck.
Okay, excellent. Well, I'm at that age now, all my friends are getting married, and married people forget how horrible it is being single. They love to call me and complain about their coupley problems. Always get, you are so lucky being single. I get home, my wife just starts nagging, nag, nag, nag. I'm like, hey, I have to nag myself. I get home, I'm like, what time do I call this? Why don't I ever do the dishes? Sometimes I think I don't appreciate myself. I haven't always been a comedian. I did some weird jobs. I used to clean houses, and I'll admit I was tempted to steal. I didn't steal because the Bible says, thou shalt not steal, but nowhere does it say, thou shalt not swap. I took a stereo, left a Walkman. Took a plasma screen, left an Etch-a-Sketch. As I mentioned, I am from Africa. I moved here 10 years ago. And immediately I moved here, I heard a lot of British people talking about the financial crisis, the recession. I'm from Africa. What are you maniacs talking about? You call that a crisis? If that's a crisis, where is UNICEF? Where is Bono? I have not seen one Save the UK concert. You can tell me it's a financial crisis when there are planes flying over Birmingham tossing fish and chips out the window. It will be a financial crisis when there are ads on television saying this chav has to walk 5 miles a day to get a bottle of WKD Blue. And 100%, you have got a financial crisis when India starts opening call centers here. Can you imagine some poor guy in Mumbai calls his bank, ends up talking to a Brummy? Thank you so much, Brummy.
My name's Axel Blake and I'm from West London.
So Axel, what made you sign up for BGT this year?
Well, I've got a 12-year-old son, he's in the audience.
Nice!
Yeah. So I just wanted him to believe in yourself, you know? Put your mind to it and you can make it happen.
And do you have a day job?
Yes, I do property maintenance. If you need a kitchen done, Simon, let me know.
I do actually, Axel.
Give me a call.
I will.
Good.
I want a good rate.
No.
We're friends now.
Yeah, okay, cool. Press that and we're cool, yeah?
I'm really curious with you, because you've got your day job, this obviously is what you want to do. Has there ever been a moment where you've almost lost your confidence and thought, I'm not going to do this?
100%, it's been that time. But when you have family that's looking at you and inspired by you, that's what keeps you going. Yeah. So my son and my daughter, that's the reason. That's the reason.
All right, well, we wish you the best of luck. Go for it.
How are we doing, ladies and gentlemen? Make some noise. I was going to drive here today. I realised I don't have a licence. So. Don't worry, I drove anyways. I took the tube. I've got a love-hate relationship with the tube, you know? I love when it's empty, I hate when it's packed. Can't stand it. Fight people off for the armrest. You ever done that? Think, no, you don't. This old lady is strong. Oh my. Have it, Margaret. Have it. Just have it. Some people do their makeup on the tube as well. Make some noise if you've ever done your makeup on the tube. Woo! Legend. A couple weeks ago, I saw a woman, she was doing her whole makeup. A few stops later, she was a whole new person. I was so impressed, I started clapping. I was like, you know what? Yeah, you know. She looked down on me like, I thought, you may be a 9 out of 10 now, but you was a -2 at King's Cross, love. Yeah. Boom. Yeah. I walked off the train like this, in style, yeah. But on a brighter note, just recently my fiance gave birth to a little baby girl. Don't clap, Simon, don't clap. I didn't say the baby's mine, did I? I'm joking, she's mine. Pandemic baby as well, you know? Aww. Yeah, so we wanted to give her a fitting name, so we named her Pfizer, yeah? Yeah. I call her Faisha, yeah? Faisha.
Oh, he's very good.
Technology is moving at such a crazy speed. Evolving crazy. You got the metaverse, you know, you got cryptocurrency. I still get excited about my contactless card when I use it. I do, when I use it. Beep. I love the noise. I've got a jacket with a pocket on his arm. Sometimes I'll leave my card in the arm and I'll pay with my arm. Just to confuse the cashier. That'll be £19.30. Next week I'm going back, I'm gonna leave my card in my back pocket. I'll be £22.60. Boop. Yeah. Yeah. Then I walk off in style. Yeah. Who's in a happy relationship? Make some noise. Yeah, me and my fiance have been together for years, 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 years. And my friends ask me, how do you do it? How are you together for so long? Through the pandemic, baby. And I just say, find your woman that, you know, loves you, understands your flaws, and find your woman that has a good sense of humor. Just make sure those three women don't find out about each other. That's the trick. Yeah, but we don't really have issues. In fact, I'm like, the biggest issue we have is I hate when she would imitate my voice in an argument and it sounds nothing like my voice. I can't stand it. She come up to me, I asked you what time you're coming home and you said to me, I don't know when you're coming home. I don't sound like that. Yes, you do. What I do now, I've got a way to get her back. I imitate her voice back and guess what? She don't like it. I did tell you what time I was coming home and you said, well, make sure you come back at a decent time. I don't sound like that. Yes, you do. She gets angry. Get out of my face, get out of my face. I say, all right, I'll get out of your face, but how do I do it? In style.
Yay. In style.
My name's Axel Blake, thank you.
What did you think?
A comedy superstar is born tonight on that stage. So funny. You made it all seem so effortless. You got a wonderful, so likeable personality. And everything you said was brilliantly funny and original. I loved it, Axel.
Thank you.
Well done, Axel. Super, super, super confident. The first person, honestly, who's ever made a joke about COVID and was funny. I know it's a bit of a cliche, but, you know, after what everybody's gone through over the last couple of years, boy, A, we needed this show back on air. We needed acts like you. There's one thing I have to tell you, though. I kind of like a granite top. I like a waste disposal unit. I want 25% off, and you get this.
Yeah! We needed you. Absolutely brilliant. Good for you.
Hi. What's your name?
Hi, my name's Nabil Abdulrasheed, and I'm from Croydon, South London.
How old are you?
I'm 34.
34. Why are you here today?
I've spent so much time doing other stuff, but now I want to pursue this. It's going to give me a chance to chase my dream and spend more time with my kids.
But you've been harbouring a dream, have you, for the whole
yes.
of your life?
Oh, yes. Or a nightmare, depending on how you look at it. I mean...
Well, look, we don't know what you're going to do. We like to be surprised. So, Nabil, take it away.
So, Sky and all people, you all right? In case you haven't figured it out, yes, I am a stand-up comic. My name is Nabil Abdulrasheed, and I am a Muslim, which is something... I'm not gonna lie, that's not the reaction I was expecting. I have to announce that I'm Muslim because people never seem to realize I am until it's too late. Recently, like, it was my birthday, right? So my colleagues found out it was my birthday. One of them was like, yo, fam! It's your birthday, cuz. Say nothing, fam. Say nothing, fam. Man's got you, fam. Man's got a surprise for you, rude man. I said, why are you talking like that? You're Irish. And he said, took me out. Where did he take me? A bar for a cocktail party. I'm like, bruv, you know I don't drink. He said, yeah, yeah, yeah. I know you do the Muslim thing, but it's your birthday, rude boy. Loosen up. It's my birthday, so what next? Hey, Nabil, I know you have a nut allergy, but you see this peanut butter sandwich, fam? It's banging. Loosen up.
It's good, man.
Because people tell me I don't look like a Nabil Abdulrasheed. Apparently, I look more like a Tyrone. Or a Marlon, or maybe even a Babatunde, you know, whatever. I turned up to a show recently. They wouldn't let me in. I turned up to the group like, excuse me, you can't be here. This green room is for a Nabil Abdulrasheed. I'm like, no, it's Abdulrasheed. Yes, that's what I said, Abdul Shish Kebab. But my mother said, I don't mean to offend you, but has anyone ever told you that your name sounds a bit Muslim? I said, yes, that's because I am a Muslim. He said, okay, well, at least tell me what the name means. I said, the name Nabil Abdulrasheed basically means that my phone calls are monitored. Now, the annoying thing about being Muslim in 21st century Britain is you know the MI5, Prevent and Home Office listening on your phone calls, but they don't go halves on Nabil. They follow you on Twitter, they don't retweet. They follow you on Facebook, but they don't poke. Well, not on Facebook. They poke you at the airport. I think. That's my time, man. Back.
Loved it. I absolutely loved it. It was fantastic.
The writing is perfect, the delivery is perfect. I want to say thank you for coming on this show and bringing this style of humour, because it makes the show grow.
I didn't think I was going to do that today, but it just felt right. You are a breath of fresh air.
Give your all to me. Give my all to you.
Hello, everybody. You all right? I'll tell you a little bit about myself. I'm a Baptist minister, actually. Most people don't know what that is, I have to explain. It's a bit like being a vicar or a priest, but I don't wear frocks. As long as we don't count Tuesdays, because that's my day off, I can do what I want. And me and my wife are the same cup size, so that comes in handy. I'm married. I've been married for 30 years, over 30 years now. Thank you. We all know what it means. It just means my love life has become a bit like my bank card. Contactless. There are other similarities I don't like to talk about. The fact that I don't have to worry about pressing any buttons. Transactions are quicker than they used to be. And I'm constantly getting declined, so...
Very good.
It wasn't that way in the beginning. Oh, no, it was all welcome gifts, high interest and instant access. Now it's flat rate, no interest, and I need 3 to 5 days clearance, to be fair. And I had to train to be a minister of a church. Can't just turn up, I had to train. I'm still on probation, to be honest. But that's kind of cool where I live, so that's all right. Sometimes I take my watch off, put it around my ankle, cover it with my sock, just to get in character. With all that training, you think I'd be good at my job, wouldn't you? I'm not. I'm really not. You know, because they don't teach you what you need to do. You know what they taught me? Hebrew and Greek.
Greek?
I'm from Bootle, right? Seriously, the only Greek I know is Stavros does me kebabs, right? And Hebrew's when a guy puts the kettle on. Good night and God bless.
Good luck.
Do I just start then?
To start.
Do you think it'll be any good?
No.
Hello! My name's Graham and it's now time for some magic. And for my magic tonight, I'm going to need a glamorous assistant. Amanda, could you join me on the stage? Let's have a big cheer for Amanda, everybody!
Woo! That big enough for you?
Now, what we're going to do tonight is me and Amanda are going to do some magic. First of all, I'm going to start with a simple magic trick. So I've got some cards here tonight. I've got a birthday card. I've got a wedding card. I've got a get well soon card. I've got welcome to your new home and happy birthday, generic pink. So I'm going to place the cards face down because that's what all the magicians do. What one do you want to go for, Amanda?
This one.
That one. Have a look, Amanda. Lovely. And I will now predict what card Amanda has picked. Amanda?
Yeah?
I've forgotten what one it was. Now, Amanda, I've written a word on the piece of paper just here. Do you know what the word says?
No.
No, that's correct. No. And now I have two cups and a bottle of water. I'm going to tip water in that cup like that. As water going in that one, I'm going to tip water in that cup like that. A little bit more in that one, a little bit more in that one. And now, before your very eyes, me and Magic Amanda will make the water disappear. Amanda, if you put the cup on your head like that, Amanda, could you hold that with one hand for me? Trust me, Amanda, I am a magician. So we're going to do the magic water dance. And ladies and gentlemen, the magic water dance will make the water disappear. Let's do this, yeah. Right. Okay, I'll do the dance first. You go right foot, left foot, left foot. You turn around, you face the back, you bend your knees 3 times. and then you wiggle your bottom three times. Yeah. Now, mate, the rules need to be your turn. Off you go. Right foot, left foot, left foot. Shove it down, face the mat. Three knee bends, three bottom wiggles. Give her a big cheer, everybody. The water dance has made the water disappear. Do you cut feel lighter, Amanda?
No.
That's a problem. I'll go first. Here we go. Three, two, one. Yeah! Amanda, trust the magic. I promise you, if you trust the magic and believe in the magic, you will not get wet. Slowly turn it over. Do you want me to ship it over for you? Go, Amanda. Trust the magic, Amanda. Three, two, one. That is magic. Ladies and gentlemen, big cheer for Amanda. Wow, you're amazing, Amanda. I don't feel quite so nervous now. Honestly, you've made me happy today. My mum would be ashamed if she knew I was here today. She thinks I'm in prison.
Hello.
Hello, darling.
Hello.
Hello, what's your name?
My name is Robert.
How old are you, Robert?
I just turned 30 11 years ago. So.
Is this your job, or do you have a normal job?
I teach tiny little primary school children music as well, so I do that, which is nice.
Okay, best of luck.
Right, so basically, I've written a song specifically for you, which makes me nervous, and also I'm slightly nervous because I've got something called dyslexia, which was very good for music, because when I was young, I taught myself the piano, although it's not so good as I'm older. I recently tried to book tickets for Rihanna, and I booked tickets for Ryanair. thank you.
Oh, very good.
I've got something called Asperger syndrome, which means I'm a genius. No, it's nice to be here. I've had a bit of a rough week. I've actually moved into a flat with my boyfriend, yes, boyfriend, gay, and autistic, two ways I can't think straight. And thank you. And
that is a good one.
So I usually, when I do clubs, I swear a lot. So I've got to be PC. I've done a song which is literally PC because it's about computers. And I have done it three times, and each time people have laughed, so if you don't, you're wrong. Here we go. Here we go. Thank you. George Formby, working in a computer shop. I work in the computer shop, make a computer bright and clean. So much crumbs and vomit, and don't ask what's on the screen. I do half the work, charge double the time, but you wouldn't want a job like mine if you would find the things I'd find when I'm cleaning Microsoft Windows. David Walliams wanted to update his content reminder. He brought me a massive ring binder. But when I looked, all the contacts were from Grindr. Cleaning ropes up windows. Alicia Dixon's webcam was another case. She said the picture was awful, but actually it was just her face.
No.
Was too lovely, her face was too lovely. There you go. Amanda Holden was the only one whose Instagram was on the mark. She said her outfits have so much spark. I said, I'm just jealous I'll never dress like you because I don't shop in Primark.
I'm okay with that.
Cleaning Microsoft Windows. Simon Cowell's Facebook was around the bend. He brought it to me to try to mend. It wasn't broken. He's just got no friends. Cleaning Microsoft Windows.
Oh, Robert, I love you.
Wow.
I mean, everything you said was hilarious. You're just a beautiful soul. Comedy flows from you like water. I love that you had a go at us all. I think some people were more hurt than others. Some was just entirely truthful. I just can't wait to see what you're going to do next.
Wow.
From start to finish, that was hilariously funny. You're a shining star. It's fantastic.
You're very self-deprecating, and I think that you have funny bones, and your audition was fabulous.
Thank you.
Really good.
Look, Robert, you know what? You're very unique, you're very quirky, very funny, very naughty. Robert. Which we like.
Thank you. Thank you.
David, yes or no?
It's a big fat yes!
Wow.
I'm saying yes.
I'm saying yes.
Robert White, you got 4 yeses. Congratulations. Lovely man.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. It is great to be here. It's great to be here on Champions Tonight. On Champions Tonight at Wembley. At Wembley.
Are you copying me?
Are you copying me?
Oh, don't start all this.
Oh, don't start all this.
It's so annoying.
So annoying. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry.
You know, he always does this.
You know, he always does this.
He will stop.
Eventually.
What's got into you tonight?
Your hand.
Don't ruin this for me. Look, we're in front of the judges. Look, there's Simon.
Yeah, there's Simon. He's alive. He's alert. He's a legend.
There's Amanda.
There's Amanda. She's cool. She's calm. She's collected.
There's Alicia.
There's Alicia. She's wise. She's witty. She's wonderful.
And there's David.
Yes. And there's David. Oh,
what?
Don't laugh. I can't talk when you laugh. And if I didn't talk, there wouldn't be any laughs.
Oh, I beg to differ.
Oh, I beg to differ.
You know, I don't need you.
No?
No. I think I could be funny without a puppet.
You're not funny with a puppet.
Well, I said you're going in there.
Mate me.
What?
Mate me.
What?
Mate me.
OK.
No, hang on.
What?
David looks quite handsome this way up.
That's it. You're going in it.
No, no, please, no, please. Please, no, closer, please. Come on.
You're making me look stupid.
Like you need help.
I'm sorry about that.
Please let me come back out.
No. Don't stop.
Please let me come.
No.
Please.
No.
Listen, if you don't let me come back out, you're going to get it.
What's that supposed to mean?
It's a threat.
Oh, I'm really scared.
You will be.
You know, I don't need a puppet to be a ventriloquist.
No.
No. All I need is one of these.
What's that?
It's a microphone. Do you know what I'm going to do with this?
I know what I'd like you to do with it.
I'm going to do my jokes.
Oh, be careful.
Excuse me?
Well, it's not as easy as I make it look.
You what?
In comedy, there's certain things you can't talk about. You've got to be politically correct.
Politically correct? I know what I'm doing. Right. There are these two Irishmen.
No.
Excuse me?
Well, you can't say that.
What? Why not?
Racist.
Racist. All right. My mother-in-law. Now, there's a...
No, no, no.
What?
Sexist.
Or this big fat bloke.
Sizist.
My grandmother.
Ageist.
David Copperfield.
Illusionist.
It's funny, isn't it?
Look, you're ruining this.
Pessimist.
This whole thing is going downhill fast.
Tobogganist.
Why don't you get stuffed?
Taxidermist.
You're on fire tonight.
Arsonist.
So no jokes then. What am I going to do?
Ventriloquist.
You've always got to have the last word, haven't you?
No.
There you go again.
Anyway, why is it always what you want?
What do you mean?
Never what I want.
Well... What do you want?
You know what I want, Paul. I want to become a real boy.
Sam, we've been through this. That's never going to happen. Look, we'll talk about this when we're alone.
You're going to talk to me when we're alone? And how long have you been single? Dreams can come true. Don't you believe in that? magic? No, Sam, I don't. Frankly, no one is going to come along, wave their arms in the air and say,
you've always lived your life as a toy. From this day forth, you'll become a real boy.
That was weird.
Paul?
Yeah?
I think you better take a look.
No.
No way.
What?
Come true. Look, Sam, you're a real live boy.
Shut it.
Ow. Ha. That's all for me. Good night.
Good luck.
Enjoy.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
What's your name?
I'm Todju.
And how old are you?
40.
And are you married?
Is that a proposal? No, not married. Not to my knowledge.
And what is it that you're doing for us today?
Stand-up, impressions.
Brilliant.
We'll wish you all the best.
Yes.
Thank you. I love TV, man. Anybody here remember Blind Date?
Ladies and gentlemen,
it's Blind Date!
And here's your host,
Miss La Black!
Oh. We've got to be bonny lads behind that screen.
I didn't expect any Drusilla. I really didn't.
And here's the gorgeous girl who's gonna meet him. Her name's Amanda. Come in, Amanda.
You know, I'd love to have seen. The screen goes back. She doesn't like the look of the guy and she makes it clear. Dun. Pretty women, why do you always come to the club with a friend that doesn't look as cute as you? Yes, and guys, just as you're about to get the cute one's number, the friend comes along and messes it up completely. Yes, let me set the scene, Alicia. Hi, you're kind of cute. Oh, you're cute too. Here comes the friend. Who are you? Then they turn to their friend. Who is he? Then they turn back to you. Are you a nutter? You look like a nutter. You act like a nutter. Can you prove you're not a nutter? Exactly what I thought. You are a nutter. If I'm not getting a man, no one's getting a man. Total Recall, Predator, Commando, action films. I love them. Favorite action hero? Arnold Schwarzenegger. Yes. Because Schwarzenegger is always asking questions.
What the hell is going on? What did I do wrong?
And he's always trying to explain his drama to other people that don't care.
Some men just tried to kill me. I think they were spies or something. Harry from work, he was the boss. Blood on my shirt, blood on my hands, blood on my knife. He tried to take my life. Get down!
Thank you. He's funny!
I like it. I really like it.
I do like it, it's funny. Wait there a second, we've got something we've got to do.
Oh my God!
Franklin.
Yes.
I don't know what to say. That really moved me. I mean, Anton Deck, thank you so much, boy.
He's good. He's very good. He's good.
Well done.
There's no one out there that I can think of right now who's like that.
See you in the studio.
Well done.
Go and celebrate. Well, thanks, love.
I'm talking about
nerve-wracking, though, bro.
Bro, all that was...
Hello, my love. Who are you?
My name's Siobhan Phillips. Mm-hmm. I am 42. I know I don't look it. And I'm from Wakefield.
Yorkshire. And Siobhan, what is the big dream?
I've been a performer for a long time, and I feel like I would love it if I had a venue where people have paid to come and see me. Do you know what I mean?
I do know what you mean.
That'd be great.
OK, good luck.
Come on, girl.
So I don't know if you've noticed, but there's a piano forte behind me, and I'm going to sit down. I'll get further away, but you'll still be able to see me. What I've done, I've written a song, because a couple of years ago I became a mum for the first time. I thought to myself, what I'll do, I'll wait till I'm 40, and I'm really old and tired, and then I'll have a baby. So I wrote a song, because they always say you should write songs about subjects with which you are familiar, but I couldn't think of a melody around cake. So, I've put a little song together, and I hope you like it. You can join in, but you won't know it because I've written it, so. Had a baby at 40, what did I do? I haven't slept since I look 102. I've piled on weight, they say, when is it due? I answer through gritted teeth, she's just turned two. I stand on plastic dinosaurs every single day. I dream of killing Peppa Pig in a brutal way. And I would strangle Mr. Tumble with his spotted bag. And if it wasn't for Prosecco, I'd probably go mad.
Yeah.
Kids, kids, oh what fun. I sometimes wish that I'd become a nun. Then she smiles at me, and I do it all again. But I think I'd skip the toddler years and push her out at 10. Push her out at 10 and then sleep again. I hate my life. Going to the loo alone would be a special treat.
Right? Yes.
I love to read my Kindle when I'm lying on the beach. I need to join the gym again. It pains me to admit I accidentally put my bra on backwards and it fits. If I hear the question why again, I think I might just scream. But at least she's far too young to discuss the Brexit deal. And I only want what's best for her to have a happy life. I'm keeping all my bits crossed, she'll be Eric Cowell's wife.
My name's John Archer.
How old are you, John, if you don't mind me asking?
I'm just a little bit younger than Simon. 58.
So why Britain's Got Talent now?
I have thought about it and I've chickened out. And so I got to the point this year, I thought, face your fears and do it. And so I'm here.
OK.
Do you know what? This is going to sound, it's going to sound bad, but I've been doing this for 23 years. Mm-hmm. And... my wife and my family. I'm all right. No, don't do that. My wife and my family have missed out on me because I've got a gig and right. My kids have missed out on Dad when I'm away. And I really just want... I want to make them proud. I know it sounds corny. Sorry.
No, it doesn't at all.
doesn't sound corny at all, John.
Sounds lovely. Have you brought anyone with you from your family today?
No, I haven't, because they'd make me too nervous if they were here, really.
Well, listen, John, just go for it.
I will, I will.
Wishing you all the best of luck.
I'll have a good time. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. It's great to be here this evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to do a trick, and I need somebody to come up and help me. And David, that's going to be you. Do you mind coming up and joining me? Give David a big round of applause.
Hello.
Excellent. Good to see you, David. Now, so what we're going to do, David, is in this bag is a prediction. It's a drink. And in the moment, you're going to choose a drink from one of these cards.
Yeah.
You could have wine, you could have tea, you could have beer, you could have milk, you could have cola, you could have vodka, you could have orange. Now, I need to let the audience in on how the trick works. So would you do me a favour? Would you just turn and face that corner for me? That's wonderful. Now, ladies and gentlemen, this is the drink that I think David is about to choose. OK. Now, what happens, I'm going to mix these cards up so that David hasn't got a clue where all the different... Where are... I'm not used to working just a big venue, to be honest. Actually, I'm not used to working. But, David, you can turn around now. Wonderful. Just want you to touch one of the cards for me, David. And whichever card you touch is the drink that we will choose. So, what, this one here?
Yeah.
Can you hold your hand out flat for me? Wonderful. I'm going to place this card on your hand. Excellent. Now, in a nice, loud voice, would you read out the name of the drink that you selected?
Cola.
Suppose you want to see my prediction, do you? It's cola, ladies and gentlemen! There it is! Pretty much it. David, I'd like you to have this bag. There you go. David Williams, ladies and gentlemen!
Very good!
David, oh!
John, you know what? They don't make you like this anymore. Do you get this reaction from this audience? It's amazing. Good for you.
John, what I loved was the Tommy Cooper retro thing that entertained thousands of people for years, and that is what Britain's Got Talent is all about.
But there's some comedians, they just walk on and you've already got a smile on your face because they just exude comedy and you're one of those people. You are super, super funny.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, they've said it all, John. I'm going to kick this off with a yes. It's a yes from me.
It's a yes from me.
You got four yeses.
Thank you very much.
Where are you from?
I'm from South Norfolk.
What's your day job, Ben?
I do this act.
OK, I'm not going to ask what it is because we like surprises.
Lush.
Tell me why you've entered the show this
Lush.
Year.
Well, my two little boys, they say, come on, Daddy, you've got to be on Britain's Got Talent.
So you've got sons, you've got kids.
I've got two children.
OK, anything else?
Yeah, well, they did have a cat. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I won't go there. All right, Ben, good luck.
Thank you ever so much. Well, you see, I think my little stint now is all about me mishearing lyrics in music, see? I mean, it all started when I went to see The Lion King. Anybody see The Lion King? Yeah. Oh, I love The Lion King, but I must have misheard something, right? Because I thought the first song was about the Arsenal club football manager.
That's funny.
What I did then, right, I had a little think to myself. I thought, oh, maybe there's other songs, right, that you can hear that you think maybe they're singing something different, right? So I've amalgamated loads, and it's just for you. Hit it, Shirley! You are the Come on,
Yeah.
Thanks for listening.